Parental discretion is advised.
This show is brought to you by Slice on Broadway. Supporting Pittsburgh podcasting with the perfect pepperoni pizza. SliceOnBroadway.com. IndieWrestling.us. Check out IWC, RWA, and more. Click the Fight TV link on WrestlingMayhemShow.com to support this show and watch pro wrestling, MMA, boxing, and so much more. And listeners like you, support this show at Patreon.com/WrestlingMayhemShow. It is the Wrestling Mayhem Show. Mike Sorg at Sorgatron on the Twitter in Mayhem Studio in Pittsburgh, PA, and a little bit more mayhem than usual. Not because of the people like last week, but more because of bug extermination. You'll have to watch Gold for that. But anyways, with me, a whole host of people. First of all, back with us. Uh-oh, messed my numbers up. Where's he at? Chad the Shad is with us back in studio.
Hello.
Hey.
I'm back. How you doing? Thanks for coming out.
And you're safe from the bug.
And safe from the bug. The voice of Missy, producer of the show, off camera as well, joining us as well. Hi. Also, Mad Mike up in Poughkeepsie, New York, the only one of us on the show with a future endeavor letter from the WWE.
That is correct. They got rid of me before the getting was good.
Okay. Wait, on your end or theirs? I'm not sure.
Yes.
How? Okay.
Yes.
All right.
It just didn't work out. Sort.
Well, you know, eventually you could have ended up in the Andre the Giant Battle Royal on the pre-show. But anyways,
If I was on SmackDown, I can just declare it. If I'm on Raw, I have to do some bullshit for it. So.
Yeah. It sounds about right. You know, different standards. Also with us from Johnstown, PA, Flowtown, USA. It is Bobby FJ Town.
Can't wait for that 7-hour Pitbull concert, everybody. Sunday.
Welcome to my house.
Welcome to Bobby's house, yeah. Guys. And also with us on the couch, first of all, Larry, Mutilator Larry.
What's up?
Back with us. He did not watch 205 Live.
I did not.
He was on the way.
You have one job.
One
job, Larry.
I don't know why I put this
What
in.
Are you listening to no, right now? You just...
It's a prop.
You're listening to another podcast.
It's like they're used to
it. It's like the laptops for AwesomeCast.
Oh, okay. I got you.
Nobody actually has anything on those laptops.
No,
it's just an empty Word document.
No, it's not even on. There's not batteries attached to it.
And also with us, we just did an Indie Mayhem show recording with her. Jinx joins us.
Hi.
A wrestler. Pro wrestler extraordinaire.
Wrestler.
Just debuted with Black Diamond Wrestling and International Wrestling Cartel.
Yay.
Nice. Find out more about her, of course, on Indie Mayhem Show coming out later this week. So, and check her out on IWC's shows as well.
Yes.
So this is your Wrestling Mayhem Show. You can check us out, of course, WrestlingMayhemShow.com. You can subscribe to us on iTunes, Stitcher, Spreaker, iHeartRadio, or the video versions on the Wrestling Mayhem Show Facebook and YouTube page. Also, make sure you subscribe to those pages because we have Facebook Lives like this show here on Tuesday nights, live.WrestlingMayhemShow.com, starting at 10 p.m. Eastern. Sometimes we'll have an interview. Sometimes we get right into the show. Either way, make some coffee. We'll be here for a while. So you'll get the notifications when we go online for that if you're on Facebook. And sometimes we do YouTube Live with our midweek wars and our Raw wrap-ups and everything like that. So get all the streams so you can join us live and we can bug you in the middle of the night whenever we do midweek war with Mike.
Bug, it's funny because we just killed a bug.
Yes, it is. Oh, it's the greatest Mayhem Show Gold we probably ever recorded. Anyways, starring producer of the show.
Puns.
As always, thanks to our friends Basic Sickness for the intro music. You can also drop us a line. Tell us about your bug killing measures at that email address.
Good times
at WrestlingMayhemShow.com or 412-206-WMS0. Put in your phone. Call us. After WrestleMania, when you're drunk and mad about Goldberg, please,
spend the time. If it takes longer to dial us than the match actually does,
it might.
We want to hear live reactions.
Oh, absolutely.
Yes.
It's going to take longer
mad
to pick up
Goldberg
the phone.
Mad about Goldberg was my favorite 80s sitcom.
Paul Reiser was great in it.
Yeah.
What's that?
Put us on speed dial now.
Speed dial now. That's right. Because you blink, you might miss that match. Also, thanks to our Patreon supporters. Of course, we had a huge week last week with the Patreon in the Bank week for Mayhem Mania. So once again, big shout outs to our friends at Fan of the Show, dollar level at patreon.com/wrestlingmayhemshow. Bo Diggity! Woo! Of course, Ed Burke and his fantastic handmade ice cream. The Matthew and Jennifer Garland's Foundation for Podcast Betterment. Oh, Ed, you left some stuff here. That spoon looks really important. So if you want to come back, feel free to bring back more ice cream.
There is no spoon.
No, there is a spoon, and there is definitely ice cream with it. Traygar, check out breakingtrayfabe.wordpress.com for him. Bobby F. J-Town and at the Pocky Club. $5 level where they get to watch Missy running around attacking animals of a bug nature. At that level, Tina Keys, Mad Mike, who is also known as the American Kevin Owens, and Christopher Bishop. Thank you so much, guys, for supporting the show and making mayhem happen. And thank you, Billy Johnson, once again for the Fuck That Al shirt that is on Roman Reigns here in the studio. You've seen it in the pictures. I was considering having Jinx wear it this week, but I don't want to mess up any future opportunities for her. So
I'm just immediately blacklisted from everything.
Yeah, just like, you know, so, you know, DJ Z
like
can't help you.
Has
you know,
to go.
Yeah. So, but anyways, it is WrestleMania week.
Yay.
One lone yay.
And there is so much happening. Last count is 13 matches.
Jesus.
13 matches.
Well, there's 10 matches on WrestleMania.
Plus, okay, we'll get into that conversation in a minute, but just bear with me for now, okay? We have 13 matches plus a Pitbull concert.
Yeah.
So
don't forget
plus whatever the New Day is doing.
They're going to be making ice cream for everyone.
Plus the Undertaker.
No, they're not. They're making fucking Freezy Pops. They've been lying to us this whole time.
Oh, are you saying that there's like, scoop?
They debuted it when
scoop.
They went
it's
to
funny
Wall
because
scoop.
Ice cream.
Oh, God.
So it's not the only one with puns tonight.
What's that?
So you're not the only one with puns tonight.
That was me.
Yeah, that was her.
Low hanging.
No, I'm kidding.
Oh, boy.
Oh, here we go. Here we go.
Edge versus Jinx.
That Asian family is still convinced.
Yeah.
We picked them up on our shoulders and everything.
Yes, we did. We were talking about that earlier.
We were talking about the Asian family that I took a photo with.
Oh, yeah. They were convinced.
That makes me happy.
Ecstatic.
Yeah.
Accidental cosplay.
Oh.
There's a story in there for another time if you guys haven't heard it yet. But
anyway, probably on an old episode.
There's a video of it, I think, on my YouTube.
There's a good point here. Like, So WrestleMania starts at like 5 p.m. for us here on the East Coast, right?
Yeah.
Tina says it starts at 2 p.m. for her out there on the West Coast.
No.
All day.
Well,
so
that's WrestleMania brunch.
WrestleMania brunch. Yeah, that's right. What's that, Larry?
It's a good thing it's on a Sunday.
Yeah, absolutely. Right? So, anyways.
Hey, at least it starts
from
early
church
for
WrestleMania.
Wait, hold on, guys. Mike, what did you say?
At least it starts earlier for our UK friends now.
That's true. Yeah. That's true. What about you, Bobby?
I just said you can go straight from church to WrestleMania.
Yeah.
And you can get to bed at a decent hour.
It's still gonna go to like midnight.
Yeah, it's still gonna go forever.
It just like somehow it's weird and automatically still stretches the midnight for them despite starting 3 hours
their
early.
Their pre-show is 3 hours longer.
Yeah, exactly. Exactly.
It's
all
just
right.
A lot of Renee Young futzing around, just like messing with her hair.
It's an hour
making
fly
by. I would watch.
It's just a lot of awkward
puke. Just watching it.
A lot of awkward statement, like awkward hanging out with Renee and Booker T and you know
Jerry.
And Jerry.
It's just
gonna at least take
an endless loop of Booker T saying shucky ducky quack quack for like 3 hours.
It's gonna at least take an hour for everybody to get down that ramp.
Oh yeah. Let's talk about the pictures have been out. Somebody did a flyover and the set has been being set up and I don't think I have it immediately available. I'll see if I can find it here. But this thing looks ginormous. And of course, I mean, we've been in this they've been in the stadium before. But I don't remember it being this long.
They're gonna.
Why is there a Death Star?
I hope
why,
they do.
Yeah, why is there a Death Star at the end of the
why
ramp?
Why is there a Death Star? I need to know why there's a Death Star.
Sister Abigail's going to hatch out of it at the end of the night.
Oh, my God.
The new gobbledygooker.
It's going to be like the fucking Enchantress from Suicide Squad.
Oh, only
she's going to be like wiggling out, like taking control of Randy Orton.
Only if Mean Gene introduces and dances with it in the ring.
No, it's going to be Al Roker now.
Okay,
right. Al Roker's on the card.
This is the weird.
And Samoa Joe isn't.
We have to include him in Mayhem Mania.
Is this so? This is an all over the place WrestleMania card, but still, you're hard pressed to find kind of a bad match in general, right, Larry?
No, that's not true.
Wait, Larry, why?
That John Cena match is going to suck ass.
Oh, no.
Come on.
Did you watch SmackDown tonight?
Yes, I watched SmackDown tonight.
I'm more excited for that match and Kevin Owens and Jericho than any other match on the card now. I'm serious.
That's correct. Bobby is exactly right.
Yeah, yeah.
That hype tonight was so good.
I'm excited for anything Miz does ever.
Mm-hmm.
Miz is on another level right now.
He just doesn't. He's at the I don't care about anything level now, and it makes me happy.
Mm-hmm.
He's hit his midlife crisis.
I don't think the wrestling is going to live up to the promos.
Yeah.
Hold on, guys. Do a little bit of crosstalk. What was that, Larry?
I don't think the wrestling is going to live up to the promos.
Mm-hmm.
I think because the promos have been amazing all month, all month long.
Mm-hmm.
But I feel like the match is going to be flat.
It's going to be such a long night. And I feel like you're going to run into, I think whatever is in that last hour is screwed. Just like Triple H and Roman last year, right?
You got Triple H and Roman was way too long though.
Well, it didn't matter. It didn't matter what they did, and they had a hell of an intro.
It would have mattered. That match was almost a half hour, and that's before the intros.
Mm-hmm.
That was just way too fucking long last year.
I think that Miz Cena match it is going to be the shortest match on the card.
You think so?
No, it's not.
I can believe that.
I can believe that solely because of Nikki Bella.
Yeah.
I don't think that Nikki Bella can go that long.
I think John Cena's proposal at the end will be longer than the actual
probably
match. No, I'm not saying that's actually going to happen. Actually, probably will happen.
Plus the introductions by Al Roker. I mean,
yes.
Oh my God. Know. If Al Roker doesn't die going down the ramp.
They're going to do it.
He's going to party again. He's going
to Royal Rumble.
Yeah.
Oh my God. I want to see Taker walk that ramp.
It's going to be a big
sign. It's going to be 45 minutes.
Going
to
be a big
that's what the extra hours for.
Like that a ray of sunshine will take them.
Okay,
to the
that would make me
back.
Really happy.
That's it.
That would make me happy.
Just a ray of sunshine.
Yeah, Roku will appear like the Undertaker, just out of nowhere. Raise the lights.
Undertaker's getting dropped off by a Black Hawk helicopter.
That's why the ramp is so long.
He's going to bring back the American badass.
Can I just say one thing?
He's on a motorcycle.
Hold on, Bobby, go ahead. Undertaker
thoughts?
Can I say
one thing about The Undertaker?
Hmm.
Did he try to scare Roman Reigns like a bear? Like you would scare a bear? Like he tried to scare him like a bear.
He did.
Yeah, he just tried to show them that he was bigger than him.
Which he is.
You know?
He's like,
Roman, I'm bigger and more imposing than you. Look. I have a jacket.
And if you
I dyed my hair.
And then we're just gonna turn the lights off.
That's the
match. No one's going to say anything about this after this happens.
All right, here's a look. By the way, if you haven't seen this yet, if you're on video, here's a look at the set that's been going around. This is mirror.co.uk. First of all, this Death Star, like you mentioned, or is that a roller coaster? What is that going to be?
I think it's a roller coaster.
I wouldn't be surprised if they're sponsored by AT&T.
I think. Oh, yeah, they probably.
And
say, I think they might be.
If they ride a roller coaster to the ring,
yeah,
that would be awesome.
We got a giant circular thing in the middle. They're the big
that's
WrestleMania
the
sign.
That's
the
sun.
You think that's going to be
the
sun?
Is
it going to be like remember those couple years where there were like some like They had these LED, like, there was a cube one year, and then there was, like, a circle that, where they just lowered in the middle of the ring when, like, Randy Orton won or something.
Yeah.
And he's posing in front of it, you know.
That was the year
Edge, there was a cube, there was a pyramid, there were a bunch of different shapes.
Yeah, so, I mean, it feels like that kind of thing. They got people kind of climbing up on
maybe
this.
That's the sphere they're going to put Roman in so he can't hear the boos.
No.
It's his safe space.
No. It's a giant hamster ball! It's a giant hamster ball! That's how everyone's going to run down instead of a cart.
That I especially Undertaker.
I want Braun in it.
Mojo.
Braun hamster
ball. If I could leave this hamster ball, I would. But I don't wanna.
It kind of looks like a giant overgrown hamster. That's how in the face.
That's how they trap the Undertaker. He just appears, and he just appears in the hamster ball, and he can't get out. It's like, wait a minute.
Well, I was going to talk about the matches, but this is a lot
practicing.
More fun.
Oh, sorry.
It's all right. We digress. No. Well, there's some digressing.
We'll talk about this with the matches.
So, I was happy to see, and I don't know what, I know I'm off mic. I was happy to see, and I was, that you know, in the listings of these 13 matches, we do see, at least in order of importance, that the WWE title with Randy Orton and Bray Wyatt is still listed above the Universal title match with Brock Lesnar and Goldberg.
That's good.
We have that going for us. Whether that actually becomes the case, I know it's not a final thing. I love that hashtag giant hamster balls is now on Twitter, I just saw.
Yes.
Thank you for that. So
Sorg, that match may open the show.
What, the Brock match? Or
no, the Bray Wyatt Randy Orton match.
Okay, it's very possible. I mean, they could put these. This is not the final order or anything like that. This is just kind of a listing. But I'm looking at this. We got whatever is going to happen between Seth and Triple H. Again, I'm thinking that's like a Bret Hart Vince McMahon kind of match that we're going to end up with, just because of his status right now.
It's not sanctioned too, so you know.
I think he's fine.
Wait, what's that, Chad?
It's not sanctioned, right?
Right.
So that's Stephanie and Joe, and
yeah,
maybe even Sami Zayn.
I'm thinking Finn gets involved.
That's what I was thinking.
It's got to be. Right?
I think Samoa Joe's going to interfere, and then Finn's going to come out and even it up.
I agree with that.
Finn's been wrestling Triple H on the house shows and stuff.
Yeah, well, the six man tags for the most place, but
keep showing. Well, yeah, that new picture they showed him.
Yeah,
bullet clubbing.
Yeah,
and then
whatever that was.
Bullet clubbing.
Triple H is doing the thing, and he's like, I don't know.
Yeah,
could you imagine
a weird rock paper scissors?
For those that have it, it's one of the six mans that we talked about a few weeks ago got advertised in advance, and it's Triple H and Finn standing in the ring. Triple H is trying to give the two sweet to him, and he's giving him the finger gun. Finger guns. Pew, pew.
Pew, pew.
Yeah. Thank you.
It's a weird game of rock, paper, scissors.
Yes, exactly.
That's how they played in Ireland.
Exactly.
Guys, could you imagine if it goes the other way, though?
Hmm.
If Triple H could have a stable of former NXT champions like Kevin Owens, Joe, and Finn Balor on his side, that would be amazing.
Am I the only one who thinks Seth Rollins is fine?
I think he's fine enough. I think it's just going to be a match.
Mm-hmm. I think it's just going to be a normal match. I think they pulled him from the Raws just to make sure he didn't re-aggravate it further, but I think he's fine.
I think he's just
done really well at selling.
Holds barred. Mm-hmm. Zeus is going to come out.
Oh, breaking guys up.
Because anyone
bit.
Who's seen him walk with a crutch, mm-hmm. he doesn't walk with a crutch like someone who's hurt walks with a crutch.
No. I also think he may just suck at walking with a crutch because it's not like he hasn't had practice. Like, you know,
it hurts your armpits,
like,
man.
Yeah, exactly. You know, it's just like, you know, I don't know.
Initially, I even believed that he had no injury at all.
Mm-hmm.
It never happened?
Like, at the show, they were like, ooh, I think you might have hurt something. They took him in the back, and he's like, no, you're actually fine. Just a little scare. And then they were like, ooh, bright idea. Let's just go with him being injured and recycle.
This could have been the plan the whole time.
Yeah.
Like, or at least from that point on. Which is very possible.
His rehab videos look very similar to his other rehab videos when he is actually coming back last year.
They just
like, it's the same stuff.
Peculiar. It's
the same stuff. And then I actually called him the one time they had, like, they said he re-injured it. And they're like, this is him training. It was a footage they showed before. There was one shot of him on the machine. And I'm like, they already used that shot.
I do believe.
It's all new footage, but they already used that one shot.
He was still working on the same knee and everything.
Yeah.
I do believe that he did re-aggravate it, but I think not as bad as they make it out to.
Yeah, that's possible.
I think he hurt it, but not that much.
This is all and on they're just
milking it.
I think it might have been one of those, like, you got to stay out for, like, 2 or 3 weeks.
I think he'll be fine to do a match, but, yeah.
He mule kicked Triple H that first time he came back.
That's fair. Brace.
He
that's
just fair. Straight up one leg drop kick. Like, oh, I'm like, you don't do that. If my knee's probably pretty bad, I should just kick Triple H with it and only and
you
it.
Don't, you don't YOLO, wear jeans right?
That tight. YOLO, yeah. Oh, what's that, Mike?
You don't wear jeans that tight if your knee is still hurt.
You know what?
Yeah, you don't wear jeans at all.
That is a very good point.
That is
you just
fair.
Don't.
That would take them like 40 minutes to put them on.
Unless they're them sweater jeans, those sweatpants jeans they have online.
My jeans are doubling as a knee brace.
Those sweatpants that look like jeans.
They might be like Cesaro's pants. Where
they just rip off.
Rip away.
Rip away.
Well, everybody, zip-up everybody jeans? Wears rip away pants, right? I mean... Right.
Oh, I'm wearing them right now, Sorg.
I can once, yeah. Every pair is a rip-off Mike, pair of jeans once.
Wait, Mike,
that's fair.
We know, Mike, you don't wear pants to podcast day.
Hey, that's not true. I wear shorts.
Okay.
Are they short shorts?
Who wears short shorts?
Mike wears short shorts.
Hey! Finger guns.
All right, match two on the card.
Match two.
30 minutes later.
Is it sad I'm more excited for the pre-show than I am for the main card?
What is the
no.
pre-show?
Okay. Officially, no. It's not sad. It's not sad. And we good. We meant to get into this.
As we're talking about this, we should have the like little Price is Right guy go down the ramp for WrestleMania as we're talking about the show.
The yodeler.
Yeah.
I love this idea.
Yes.
Just like real slow. And then when you get to Brock and Goldberg, he just falls off the edge and is like doo 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 doo.
All right. Kickoff show, which starts at 5. I believe the matches are gonna start after 6 PM, which I think that point is on USA Network. So of course
Chrisley.
Shut up.
Hey, he knows best.
Side note.
Blast Andre the Giant.
Side note. I'm super pissed because I'm watching, because I watch on my Apple TV and I throw the USA Network stream up there, right? It shut off after Raw last night. And now my Apple TV thinks that I really want to see the next episode of whatever the Christie
knows
best or whatever the hell.
But you do, Sword.
I'm so pissed.
They just now, want you to know best.
I have to deal with those commercials during Raw. Now my Apple TV is like, don't you want to watch Chris? I'm like, screw you. I want to watch The Flash. Leave me alone, Apple TV.
I think
Sorg,
I
that's
think
the price of being a cord cutter. That's the price of being a cord cutter right
that's
there, Sorg.
Yep.
You know what doesn't confuse Chrisley and Raw? My DVR doesn't confuse that
yeah.
shit.
Mine does.
I think Chrisley is the
thanks, Bobby. Larry.
I think Chrisley is the guest announcer for the Lesnar match.
I hope not. Get on the mic. Wait, what's up, Missy?
Tina Keys is pointing out with our Price is Right WrestleMania thing that the Price is Right is hosted by Drew Carey, a WWE
Hall of Famer.
Oh,
yeah. it comes together.
Illuminati confirmed.
So was our president. Oh,
side note, I can't.
We're not getting into that.
No. That's political mayhem show later on down the line.
Okay. PMS.
Hashtag.
Yes.
Hashtag
that's
PMS.
Perfect.
Who was I going? There's a point. Kickoff matches. Okay.
Yes.
The kickoff matches. Damn it. So
should
this is what we have for the kickoff matches. Of course, the Andre the Giant Memorial Battle Royal. Which, again, I am akinning to the Battle Royal that they have that, Chad, we were just looking at for
Wrestle
Kingdom.
Tatanka will be there.
What's that?
Tatanka will be there.
He better be there. Hell yeah.
In the match.
Which means then he'll just be, I don't know, somebody random from Night of the Superstars will be in it. Like, that seems to be the trend.
Plot twist, right
celebrity. I want a random celebrity like Penny Hardaway to show up.
How about Little Penny Hardaway?
Shaq's too fat. Oh, Little Penny Hardaway would be the best.
He'd be the special guest ref.
Yes,
I'm fully on puppet.
No, too fat for
no, with the puppet.
He lives under the ring with the little people's court. Remember when?
I like
yes.
it.
Yes.
That's when we found out Maria was smart. Right?
Mm-hmm.
That was a different court case.
Yeah.
That was the same. Yeah.
Something like that.
But then we found out she was dumb when she went to TNA.
Kickoff matches. the SmackDown Women's Championship match, you know, Alexa Bliss versus the world, basically. It actually says, and again, we talked about this before, is champion Alexa Bliss to defend against all female SmackDown Live superstars who are available to compete. What?
All of them.
The ones that can make their flight.
They did change it. What did they change it to tonight?
It's a
Bobby?
Six-pack challenge now.
It's officially a six-pack?
It's officially a six-pack.
A six-pack challenge?
No,
it's six-pack.
You can't tell me what to do.
You can still add other people.
They said it's a six-pack
challenge. The seven-pack challenge.
So Naomi's the final entrant. Spoiler alert.
Okay, all right. That's fine. Like, we're not going to have like Santina come out or something like that.
I hope she tried to get in the match.
I mean, maybe?
I would kill for Tyler Breeze to be in that match as Breezy Bell.
He tried to get in on SmackDown. He came up to Daniel Bryan and he's dressed as Breezy Bella and he's like,
that was amazing.
He's like, Daniel, I'd like to get into the women's match.
Wait, but Bryan's like, hold on a second, your sister's here. to Bree on the phone.
Can we?
You dress like a Bella, you can push.
I mean, yeah, right.
Yeah.
I mean,
can we talk about how Tyler Breeze is getting over Nikki Bella's character better than she is?
Yes, because she's better at promos.
I'd say Maurice is getting over Nikki Bella's character.
I thought tonight when that came on, I thought there was the first thing I saw was Nikki Bella, and I thought it was Maurice. And I was like, why is Maurice standing so close to John Cena? I was like, wait a second. Oops.
Tyler Breeze is better at Nikki Bella promos than Nikki Bella is.
I think this was Nikki Bella's best promo so far.
Although I think if you look at Tyler Breeze, if you look at Tyler Breeze in that outfit, nothing is more fearless.
Yeah,
that's true.
Yeah, she basically wears nothing.
You can look, but you can't touch.
Oh, no, please don't.
When Nikki was in the ring, and started taking everything off, I was like, "Is Bree back?" I didn't know.
As soon as she loses the hat, it's just
just can't tell. You know they're twins.
What happened?
Is there a tag team match or championship match for SmackDown?
No.
Nothing.
Not for tag team. Nothing. They're all involved. Everybody that was in the like 5-on-5 match is apparently in the Battle Royal.
What? Yes. Wow.
And poor Apollo Crews couldn't get in that 10-man tag.
Yeah. Yeah.
Poor Apollo Crews.
I love Apollo.
Because the Usos are Crime Time light now.
Yeah.
They are.
No, Crime Time ish.
All right, hold on. They're like the gritty reboot.
I have a question with the Usos.
Okay.
The Usos, they wear these shirts or hoodies that say day one ish.
Yeah.
Now, the ish, is it slang for shit? Like day one shit? Or are they not really twins and they were born on separate days?
They can't be. I still don't know which one is which.
Day one-ish.
I do know that only the Usos and Baron Corbin got bootleg merchandise on TV.
Wait, what's happening?
What's that Crime Time music?
Brooklyn.
You guys didn't see it, but Jinx and Chad were just like having a Crime Time dance moment over here going on. And I'm just like, what's going on?
Brooklyn. That's
bring
what their shirts should say.
Oh, jeez. Billy's saying that Apollo was one of the first to be in the Battle Royal, though. So, I don't know what the final list is, but
he should have been in that match. In the tag team match.
Hey, you know what? Road Dogg's having an off day with the dartboard.
Listen, he missed him. It missed him. Sorry.
Sometimes the dart slips.
Yep. That's right.
The luck of the draw.
Yeah, exactly.
Brother.
We've got too much good talent there. Something's going to slip through. And, of course, the biggest thing that I'm excited for on the pre-show is Neville and Austin Aries. So excited. I thought they did a great job with those two.
So good.
Kind of presenting them for the uninitiated on Raw. And I don't care if it's half an arena. These guys are going to have a killer match in there.
Mm-hmm.
So. I'm very upset we only have one Cruiserweight match from WrestleMania.
So
as opposed to last year's none.
Looking at this,
yeah.
I think there's a lot to be happy with because we're, you know, being back in the post draft era, brand split era, and we have U.S. title defended, Intercontinental title defended, one tag team. Okay,
no, they didn't do that long.
One tag team match.
They didn't do that a lot.
What
most. Most of the mid-card champions were usually in the Money in the Bank match.
Exactly, and that's why I'm saying we're doing better than we usually do. I think, you know, two women's matches, I'm kind of iffy about that one being a six-pack challenge, but okay.
Yeah.
I'm glad Naomi's
cruiserweight.
In it.
Naomi's mm-hmm. back in it. Like, there is, like, a big level of representation on here. Like, it doesn't feel like, you know, you look at this list and you're like, man, Apollo Crews didn't really get much out of this. It's like, or hell, any of the cruiserweights when you look at it. But, like, holy crap, they have how many shows, you know? And
hey, Sorg, what's Samoa Joe's match?
Samoa Joe is going to have a big to-do in this non-sanctioned match, obviously.
He's going to be dressed as Goldberg.
What?
He's going to be dressed as Goldberg the same way Tyler Breeze is dressed as Nikki Bella. And he's going to wrestle Brock Lesnar.
Oh, God. Joldberg.
I want Joldberg
so bad.
I thought you were going to say he was going to dress as a woman and make it a seven-pock challenge.
That would be funny also.
I'd love
Samoa Josephine.
Yes.
He'd still be badass. Anyways.
His entrance theme is the best thing that's ever happened to me, by the way.
He comes out that don't treat me like a woman.
Don't treat me like a man.
With China.
Oh, no. Sorry, too soon. Too soon.
Oh, no. I forgot about that. No, I'm
sad. How'd you forget about that?
I forgot she
too
died.
Soon.
I forgot. Yes, the SmackDown Women's match is on the pre-show. Cruiserweight's on the pre-show, and the Andre Memorial Battle Royal, as usual, is on the pre-show.
Hey, not as usual. It was on the main show before.
Like the first year or something
that.
Last year was on the main show, and WrestleMania 30 was on
the main show. Lean in.
You know, I think that we've talked quite a bit about this.
Yes.
I could really use some Slice on Broadway pizza.
Yes, there's Slice on Broadway, our good friend supporting Pittsburgh podcasting with the perfect pepperoni pizza. We'll get some Slice on Broadway while we're watching WrestleMania, feeding the crews, the growing crews that are happening in here in studio on Tuesday nights. Big thanks to them. Check them out, sliceonbroadway.com. And according to the Awesome Cast, we're one step closer, Bobby, to faxing you that pizza.
What?
Yeah, we talked
3D
about...
3D printed pizza?
Of sorts. So it was kind of... There was a story about transferring a lemonade case electronically.
What?
Yeah, for real. We talked about it on Awesome Cast this week.
It makes me
happy.
We're close to this fruit singularity.
Yes, with the fruits. Wait, did you say fruit singularity or fruit?
Yes, I did.
Fruit. I feel like that's a Penny Arcade joke in there somewhere.
Citrus larity.
Citrus larity.
It's like the gobstopper.
Hashtag trademark.
Bobby FJ Town Limited. Yes.
And if I can also give a nice little shout out to Tony Garza, especially concerning the fact that you turned around that requested image so quickly yesterday.
Yes.
God, Dawson's
in addition to all the awesome stuff that you've been doing for Mayhem Mania in general, you, sir, are awesome.
Let's talk about it. So Garza has been doing a fantastic job with the Mayhem Mania graphics, which we'll get into a little bit later this evening. We were tweeting out like the finalized ones, and Scott Dawson responded to us. I'll retweet this if you put us in the center, otherwise you're getting blocked.
He just said
it wasn't us, it was me.
What's that?
He said put me in the center.
We actually
may have just started the breakup of the Revival.
Oh no. so
there. It's Sean and Marty all over again.
Thank
you.
And thank you. There's the graphic corrected. It did have the Kings of Wrestling in the center before.
It's perfect.
But now it's Scott Dawson.
Just Scott Dawson.
We go hard.
He's predominantly
all day, all night.
He is
Scott
predominantly
Dawson,
the largest person on that post.
He is.
He's the main event, you guys.
You
just
is.
Him though.
He retweeted then.
No,
he's Mr. Takeover.
No flips. Just Dawson.
Yes. Make it a T-shirt, Scott Dawson.
There you go. You can have that one for free. So thank you so much. TheWrestlingRevolution.com. Check out Garza's website. Thank you so much. Yeah, he did.
Yes, he did.
Yeah,
nice.
So he did retweet it. So.
He did.
And we got some play off of that too. So
what a man.
what a mighty fine man.
Hey, he stands by his word.
He does. He does.
I would have, if we didn't fix it, I would have fully expected him to block us.
Is it fair to call him a friend of the show now?
Yes.
I think so. I think it's absolutely appropriate. We'll get more into the Mayhem Mania. What's
He's
going on with that
right now.
Later in the show, Mike.
Hi, Sorg.
Well, first of all, is there anything else WrestleMania? I mean, I think we got a lot of.
Should we do predictions?
Oh, geez, that'll take another hour. To be quite honest.
Everyone does.
Let's do them on the Facebook group. Yes, let's do them on the Facebook group.
Because I was gonna say I have a bold prediction for WrestleMania.
Okay. Let's do that. Everybody go around
for WrestleMania.
Actually, can we do this as our big question?
Yes, do that.
The big question is going to be bold predictions. Because I want to get to math.
Ooh. Oh, yeah. Yeah, I math a lot.
So Mike just finished watching 32 WrestleManias. I did this a couple years ago when it was a paltry 30 WrestleManias. Actually, 29 WrestleManias probably, right? And he did a podcast for each one. I think we're probably up to episode 28-ish. 26?
I believe 27 released today.
27 released today. That seems about right. So go check those out. They're in the stream for the Wrestling Mayhem Show Master Feed, and the videos are on the Wrestling Mayhem Show Facebook page and YouTube page if you want to go check those out and see what Mike thought of a lot of those WrestleManias. So, Mike, he likes the math on this show. It's kind of his background. So what did you math?
I was like, in retrospect, when I was talking about WrestleMania 32, I was thinking in my head, I'm like, I wonder how much wrestling I've exactly watched in the course of these 32 WrestleManias. So I made a nice Excel spreadsheet, which I will put on the Facebook group, and I mapped hours, minutes, and seconds of every WrestleMania, the number of matches, the number of title matches, the number of title changes, the number of gimmick matches, the number of celebrity matches, the number of managers, and the number of wrestlers in all 32 WrestleManias.
You lost me at matches.
It's okay. It's fine. Bobby, it's fine. I get really bored. I get really bored sometimes, Bobby. It's fine. So, all together, I've watched 110 hours, 52 minutes and 52 seconds of WrestleMania. It's a lot of fucking wrestling.
In less than a month.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Does anyone want to take a guess which WrestleMania had the most wrestlers in it?
17.
Okay. That's a wild guess. That's a wild guess.
That was the one. That was the first TLC, wasn't it?
17 was the first. 17 was the second TLC.
What was the
match?
Year with the gimmick battle royal?
Gimmick battle royal. That was also 17.
Oh, maybe it was 17. Then.
I feel like there needs to be something that was a mix of a battle royal plus a Money in the Bank match.
Okay,
I don't know if that happened. Like 23 or something.
That's my.
Right. 23 actually had one of the lower totals.
Oh, yeah. Really? Yeah. Garza, you were close.
20 from Garza.
Okay.
30 from Billy.
20 was pretty close, but the winner is WrestleMania 30.
Ooh. Ah,
it had 60 people on it.
16?
60.
60.
60.
Wow.
60?
Well, that's
60.
Two times the Royal
Rumble. Two Royal Rumbles.
Because that's the year that the Andre the Giant Battle Royal was on it.
Okay.
Was on the main show. So I don't count pre-shows.
Okay.
I didn't count pre-shows for any of these statistics.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. So does anyone want to have a guess how many, which WrestleMania had the most manager appearances?
One.
I'll give you the number. The number is 23 managers.
Wow.
What?
That's
23 managers.
Oh, God.
No. Six.
They weren't all different managers. There are a bunch of them that came out different times.
Okay.
Yeah.
Four.
Nine.
I'd say six.
Sorg is dead on.
Four.
WrestleMania four.
Think about all that
four.
Tournament. Like, you had...
That tournament.
Slick was a manager. Heenan was a manager.
Virgil.
Andre the Giant was a manager. He counts for, like, three.
Yeah, that's fair.
I shouldn't have changed. I said four.
WrestleMania 4 was also the second highest number of wrestlers.
Second highest. That makes sense.
Wow.
That makes sense. Okay.
Garza's asking if you're counting Dead Man's Druids.
Yeah, are you counting druids?
No.
You should.
Nope, I'm only counting people involved in the actual match.
Which WrestleMania had the most druids?
Go back and find out.
WrestleMania 33.
I wish.
Why do you think 33 will have the most druids?
I don't know.
Because it's the longest entranceway.
Well, I wish we could redo
the Undertaker's going to come out like a bear.
I wish all we right, could redo the Wyatt Taker match and have all the druids go against all the sheep.
Another battle royal.
He had scarecrows that year, too, didn't he?
Yeah, scarecrows. Yeah.
They're pretty awesome.
Yep.
All right. So
David S. Pumpkin skeletons.
I'll give two more math stats before we wrap this part up.
Okay.
There have been a total of 310 matches at WrestleMania.
Jeez.
Wow.
Wow.
And 117 of them have been title matches.
Wow.
Wow.
That's not bad.
Nice.
It's about a third. It's not too bad.
Well, hell, look at this year. How many title matches are on this year's card, right?
Not counting pre-show?
Not counting pre-show. And that's the thing. Your math is no pre-shows.
Yeah, no pre-shows. Oh, because if I did pre-shows, all the Battle Royals, because I can't fairly do pre-shows because there are some matches that are on like free-for-alls and stuff like that, and it's not available on the network.
Yeah, and there's like matches on free-for-alls, like on heats and things like that, right? Yeah. And even like there were dark matches at early ones too.
Yeah. Okay. Now, two more questions have to do with title changes, all right? Okay. Which WrestleMania had the most title changes?
Ooh.
34.
What was
WrestleMania 64?
What was the one Benoit won? Do you remember which year was it that Benoit won?
20.
20. I'm going to go 20.
20.
I'm going with 9.
Why?
Yeah, is that the one with the Yokozuna and Hulk Hogan thing?
Well, I will tell you, the number of title changes was 14.
Wow. Whoa. What?
Oh, there's a hardcore title in there, isn't there?
Hardcore champion.
Yes, there is.
Oh, you know what? It's got the WCW titles, too.
Yeah, there's that. But no, is that hardcore? Because there was like
so what is that?
12. There's like 12 of them. It's 18-ish or...
Garza and Keith
15?
And Tina are both saying 20.
They're saying 20.
It's WrestleMania 2000.
Wow, which was 16.
Because that had the hardcore battle royal.
Yeah.
Oh.
Where there were like 10 title changes in it.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. As soon as you said that many title changes, that's...
Well, because they all were official champions.
Hardcore 24/7.
Yep.
All right. Now, there's only been one WrestleMania where no titles changed hands. Which one was it?
One.
There's only been one WrestleMania where no title changed hands.
WrestleMania 1.
Nope.
No.
2.
No, WrestleMania 1 had, I think, 2 title changes on it.
WrestleMania 2.
No,
nope.
WrestleMania.
Do I hear 3?
28.
13.
28?
WrestleMania
13. 13? 28 is close.
Guys off already.
28 is close.
It's a recent one.
Yeah.
Is it a recent one?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, it is.
It's fairly recent.
Yeah.
29.
I will say that the no title changes has happened once in a lifetime.
Oh,
it's WrestleMania 27. That had John Cena versus The Rock.
Wow.
That was close. Yeah. I knew it was a recent one.
That's fairly recent,
Yeah.
That would be awful. Why would you book that?
I know, that's so boring. God.
I've asked, why would you book that so many different times?
I know, as a wrestling fan, I feel
wrestling,
like...
I'm sure.
That's basically Mike's part of the Raw wrap-up, was why would you book that? So.
Hashtag, why would you book that?
There have been 89 gimmick matches at WrestleMania.
What'd you do that inside?
That...
Booked it.
89. Oh.
Which WrestleMania had the most gimmicks?
Most gimmick matches.
Yeah, which one had the most gimmick matches?
Let's see. Seven.
6
is the high number, and it was WrestleMania 22.
Oh, wow.
From Chicago.
Oh, that makes sense.
Chicago.
Okay.
Chicago.
That was the one that had, like, Foley versus Edge. It had Money in the Bank.
That was
still chanting.
Right?
That was a good match.
Back right to the chest.
How did you feel after you finished that match, Edge?
Felt great.
Bloody and burnt.
Felt like, I felt very hot.
Yeah.
And felt like a Hall of Famer. And I needed to get this blood out of my eye.
vision hasn't been right since.
No. My hand was trembling. Yeah.
Still crops up on the set of...
I watch that match like once a year because it's so good.
I love that really match. I love that.
It's a really good match.
It is. Yep. Barbed wire. The hidden barbed wire.
ECW. ECW.
Oh, yeah. It was like under his shirt.
Edge went for the spear and then he just like went crazy.
Yeah.
Then he was like, oh, by the way, wrap my ribs in barbed wire.
Ha, ha, ha.
Gotcha. Got you getting me. This hurts too.
It's kind of a shame because Foley's stomach, you can't really see the barbed wire.
Yeah.
Like when he takes off, because he's wearing two different flannel shirts.
Yeah.
Which just looks odd to begin with.
Camouflage.
But like when he takes off the first one, you almost can't see the barbed wire at all.
It's
like
hidden.
To the point where, like, he would have had to hit directly on where that barbed wire was for it.
Well, Edge is very.
He's very, very precise.
Yes.
Yeah.
His accuracy is very high.
It's true.
Better than.
It's true.
Everything is accurate and perfect in wrestling.
Look at that TLC match. Spear off the ladder.
That's right.
Yeah.
That's right.
One of the best moments ever.
And we get another ladder match this year.
Yes, we do. Yes, we do.
I hope there's a spear off a ladder.
Happy
with Edge.
With.
We're just going to throw Enzo.
He just
around.
Comes out of nowhere and.
You guys, do you think that Death Star is Vanguard 3, is Vanguard 2?
Oh, yes. No, you stop that.
Leave that be, all right, Mike, any more masks for us?
Oh, I'm going to post the whole thing online, but let's see. Which WrestleMania had the fewest number of wrestlers on it?
The fewest number?
One.
Yeah, fewest.
That one was loaded with celebrities, right?
Yeah.
No, actually,
negative one.
No. The fewest number of wrestlers ever on a WrestleMania was 16 wrestlers.
Hmm.
So the roster was real thin.
That was like that Raw when they all went on strike.
Was kinda, that?
Yes.
Yeah. Was that in the 20s?
Nope. It was in the first double digits.
13. Oh, wait.
13 is close.
Which one's the Iron Man match? Because that would have taken a lot of time out. 12?
That's it, Sorg.
Is it 12?
12.
Yeah.
That's it.
Yeah.
Yeah, 12 has a lot of the low bars.
My favorite
lowest
thing.
Lowest number of matches, lowest number of titles. Yeah. Did you know the Iron Man match was the only title match on that show?
Wow.
It was worth it.
I still love like when JBL a couple weeks ago on that show they do was like, yeah, one of my first, like, I was just starting and I saw that I had to be there at WrestleMania and watch that Iron Man match and realize I don't belong here.
So, let me ask Mike, what was the most surprising compiling all this that you would not have thought about, then looking back go, oh, wow, I didn't realize.
Okay, I don't think WrestleMania 17 is my favorite WrestleMania anymore.
Oh,
wow.
Nor do I think it's the best. I think WrestleMania 24 kills it.
Okay.
Which one was that?
WrestleMania 24, like Shawn and Flair. I'm trying to remember what else.
I'm sorry.
There now.
I love you.
Shawn and Flair, it had a really good Money in the Bank match on it. Hold on. Let me just bring up the card because now I'm... Because we're also going to be doing something special in the upcoming weeks. You guys know March Madness?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. I have compiled Mania Madness for us to play next week after WrestleMania.
Excellent.
So we're going to have, because it's 32, it's a perfect number. We're going to have four sets of brackets. I've divided it into Northeast region, South region, West Coast region, and Parts Unknown region.
Is that a Southpaw region?
Yes.
That's really... Oh, God, I wish it was the Southpaw region. But 24 had some really good matches. It had the Belfast Brawl with JBL and Finlay. It had CM Punk winning his Money in the Bank match.
Mm-hmm.
It had Shawn and Ric Flair. It had the Triple Threat match where Orton beat Triple H and Cena. And it had Money Mayweather and Undertaker and Edge.
Hmm.
It was a really good show.
That's a good card.
It's awesome.
Yeah.
Well, thank you, Mike.
Because at the end of that, I screamed a lot in a bar.
Good times.
Like Edge, when Undertaker fell down, and Edge like went to, like stepped over him, was like, nah, because nobody else in the bar knew what was coming, but I knew that triangle choke was coming, and I knew it was over. Mm. So I thought maybe on the off chance he could win.
What would have been really funny in that match is if Taker sent Edge to hell and he walks out of the bar bathroom at the same time.
And that was the match with friend of the show Jimmy Carderas too.
Yeah.
So.
And it was Zack Ryder's WrestleMania debut.
Oh wow!
Huh.
Oh wow! Great. Yeah,
the Major Brothers.
Good
the Major
times.
Brothers, y'all.
10 years
Brothers.
Ago.
Jeez.
Yeah, full circle.
Well, guys, again, check out 32 Manias with Mike and everything else going on at WrestlingMayhemShow.com. Also, please check out our friends IndieWrestling.us. A lot of great stuff over there, including IWC. You can check out Jinx over there on Proving Yay. Ground 6. Yes. As well as our friends with the Renegade Wrestling Alliance. Hi, Wheel. See you in the chat room. And had a great show this past weekend that we'll hopefully get up here by the end of the week. A lot of fun and a crazy cage match with that. A lot of other friends of the show is a part of that. Guys like Super Hentai and the reuniting of the Gambino brothers. Remember those guys, Chad?
Move this.
Remember when?
Yeah, I remember.
You can see they're very into fan interaction these days.
Hey,
again.
Gambinos, move this.
What, I think I still have the original.
There's like four of us, and we all just like stood up and said, "Move this."
Yeah, we're the original crowd interaction.
There's the time that you threw change at Dennis Gregory.
I called him a bum.
And then just like threw change as feet like right in front of him.
That's
he's
amazing.
Out.
Here's your bus fare to go home, you bum. Get out of my town. Get out of my town.
Yes. We would get.
Which he rebutted as, "Why did you throw a whole month's pay at me?" And I was like, "Oh, that's clever."
We're getting the dog. Now we're getting the dog pissed off talking about Dennis Gregory. We would take soda bottles and like put change in them and just rattle them when he comes out.
Yeah. If you go back and watch old IWC and you always hear people calling Dennis Gregory a bum,
it's you. Right there.
One show, it's like, I was in the back, you're a bum.
I remember the first time I came down there when we went to an IWC show, I literally knew none of the guys there except I knew the Gambinos was a moving company. And I knew Dennis Gregory was a bum, and those were the only things I shouted.
Yeah,
and
that's all you need to know.
Everybody in the crowd would chant "bum" at Dennis Gregory, and I was like, "What did I do?" I didn't even have to say it anymore.
Yep.
Like I would just sit there and everybody chant "bum," like this is great.
Like they start turning, we just look at each other, and we're like, "All right, yep, yep."
We did.
I still have my Gambino Brothers moving hat somewhere.
I do too. I do too. I absolutely do. Anyways, go check out this. You get this fun can be had indiewrestling.us or your local indie wrestling promotion. Highly recommend it. Chachi and I still go to other local wrestling shows that we're not working and just yell at Bubba the Bulldog. We're going off another thing, but so we went to a PWX show. Bubba the Bulldog and Ron Hunt were wrestling, and Carlin's and Chachi and Weatherman and Ron Smiley comes. So we're all sitting there watching them because it was supposed to be a pretty big match, and we're just all yelling at Bubba, telling him he's old the whole time.
Right.
It was fantastic. I'll watch wrestling with Ron Smiley anytime.
Sometimes they need that motivation.
They need that. Oh, they certainly
they
do.
Yes.
Certainly do.
Absolutely.
They need haters to keep them on track.
A cup of haters?
Cup of hater?
Oh.
Yeah. Awesome. Anyways, we're going to be right back with the big question and the final Mayhem Mania selections. Somebody get Bobby a towel. We'll be right back. Let's talk tech. Tech news discussions from the people in the industry right here in Pittsburgh. Online, gadgets, startups, and more. Check it out at awesomecast.net. Wrestling Mayhem Show, big question time in studio. Of course, we got Jinx still hanging with us.
Hello.
Larry, Mutilator Larry on the Twitters.
Hello.
All your people out there.
All my tens of fans.
To all your little mutilators out there everywhere. Of course, Chad the Shad here in the studio.
Buongiorno.
Chad, I didn't know you spoke Italian.
I do.
That was French.
Bon, si, correcto.
Missy in the production seat, as well as Mad Mike coming to Poughkeepsie, New York.
Here comes the money.
What?
Why do I come back every week?
I don't know.
Because you live here.
And Bob, you have J-Town out in Johnstown.
Gornami.
So as we... as we're talking
no podcast
and,
dog.
And Wicket's out here too, barking at people. Barking at the cardboard Hulk Hogan back there. So,
to be fair, that's good taste.
Yes, right. But anyways, so it's a big question. As we said before, we're going to make our big question. What is your bold prediction for WrestleMania? Does anybody have one prepared? Well, Mike, weren't you about to give us one?
Yes. So, yes.
All right.
All right. So, I think we can all assume that John Cena is going to propose to Nikki Bella after they win their match, correct? My bold prediction, though, is that this was actually a plan of John Cena and The Miz. Is that this was actually a plan to get them together in the same match. Because John Cena usually wrestles singles matches at WrestleMania. Mm-hmm. So what's the one way to get John Cena and Nikki in the ring at the same time? Have Maurice strategically be positioned to be hit during the Natty and Nikki match. And it all goes from there. Because I secretly think John Cena and The Miz are best friends. And they cook this elaborate Barney Stinson-esque scheme up so that they can be together at WrestleMania. That's my bold prediction. Because everyone thinks that, oh, Miz is being so mean, Reese is being so mean. They're filming in John Cena's house. They had to get access to that.
That's true.
Who let them in there?
The producers.
They have Nikki's
ring gear.
That's not really
his house. WWE.
They have Nikki's ring gear.
Hey, John Cena.
This is all a plan.
Is always
welcome
unlocked.
To my house.
Always. Edge got in there real easy to slap his dad years ago.
That's true.
So Cena's houses are real easy to get into.
He doesn't have locks on his doors.
No.
He just, if anyone comes in that he is unwanted, he just beats them with his sheer muscle mass.
Yeah.
He doesn't need locks.
They just ask John Laurinaitis if they can have entry while he's doing flat back bumps in the back of the house.
All right, Larry.
Sure you can go in there.
Larry, you had one.
Yeah. So my prediction is we recently discussed how the Usos don't have a tag team match.
Mm-hmm.
I think they're going to go out and bitch to the crowd about not having a match. And the Hardys are going to come in looking for gold.
Mm.
Oh, that would make so much more sense now.
Vanguard 2.
Except I don't think that big AT&T dome is Vanguard 2. I think that's going to be part of Triple H's entrance because he's only one that can actually afford his entrance to be part of the stage rigging.
Yeah.
They look at any of the
literal Terminators.
Yeah.
Yeah, they did.
Yeah, and a Doom platform for Stephanie on the last one.
Yeah,
that was so Masters of the Universe.
It was good.
I think Triple H might do a Mad Max intro this year.
Nice.
Yeah. I'd actually be real great. Happy if he did. That would be awesome.
If he was in Morton Joe.
Oh,
we've already seen a flamethrower at WrestleMania, so it's not outside the realm of possibility.
I hope Seth ruins his entrance. And just like kicks him all the way down the ramp.
He should just shockmaster through it.
Oh, imagine
including
like,
the fall.
You know how Triple H uses NXT guys as like his minions during his entrance?
Yeah.
What if Seth was disguised as a minion?
Oh, that'd be great.
And he just like as Triple H is walking down, like looking all badass and Jack, like getting ready to spit the water out again because that's macho or something. And Seth just shows up behind him, peels off a mask. He's like, "I got you, Hunter," and just smacks him with a crutch.
I poison the water.
I just imagine like literal minions, like the Despicable Me minions.
That's what I pictured too.
And it's really funny. Crew
with little crosses.
Triple H's crew really would be funny. Pretty great.
I can't check DMs. I can't get over this.
Despicable H.
All right. Does anybody else have a bold prediction lined up here? Oh, Billy. Billy has one in the chat.
That's
he's. Oh, is that what? That's not a DM. His bold prediction.
His
bold prediction is Bray Wyatt is the only current champ that leaves as champ. Okay.
I like that.
I can see that.
Okay. My text message was check doc, not DM.
Oh, well, you know, it's kind of a thing that happens. Happy birthday, Chess Flexor.
Happy birthday, Chess Flexor.
I thought it was last week. Oh.
Happy birthday, I don't know.
I just got a notification. It's Chess Flexor's
every
birthday.
Every day is a happy birthday.
Every day is Chess Flexor's birthday.
That's right.
Chess Flexor.
Bobby FJ Town, what is your Chess bold Flexor. Prediction? What is your bold Bobby FJ prediction?
Somebody gets mysteriously taken out of that six-pack challenge by Asuka.
So it's a five-pack challenge?
Comes out, cleans house, takes the title.
I would love to see that.
That would be cool.
That'd be good. That'd be good. I like it.
Does anyone here think Alexa Bliss is going to leave with the title still?
No.
No.
I hope so, except for Asuka.
I think
Naomi is winning that
champ. I think so, too.
You think Naomi's going to be back?
Yeah. Other than Asuka.
They should have saved the Naomi reveal for WrestleMania.
I agree completely.
They probably can't now because it's on the pre-show.
Missy?
So.
Brandon thinks that Kelly Kelly will show up.
Kelly Kelly.
She has to. It'll make me hurt inside, but she has to.
Am I missing something? Why does she have to?
Well, she doesn't have to, she's coming back.
Okay. She's inducting Beth Phoenix.
Is that why? No, I thought Natalya was inducting Beth Phoenix.
I heard she was coming back to the ring, too, but she is going to be in town because she's inducting Beth Phoenix.
They said they weren't saying Natalya was inducting her. That's what they were advertising.
Yeah, it was Natalya.
I'm pretty sure it's Natalya.
Yeah. Okay, well, that makes more sense. I had heard Kelly Kelly at one point.
No. I think Kelly Kelly, from what I've heard, and who knows because of the internet, but I've heard that Kelly Kelly has signed like contracts back with the WWE, whether it's for wrestling or not. I don't know.
Has she learned to run the ropes correctly?
She learned how to do any moves other than taking her shirt off?
Well, you know, they just got...
Probably not.
Unless
they did just get rid of Eva Marie.
That's what I was
about to say. That's fair. They need one back.
They have an opening.
Kelly does hockey wise.
Yes.
USA Today is reporting that Kelly Kelly will return to WWE.
Oh, there you go. USA Today's got it.
USA Today says
now, see, Kelly Kelly has done a reality show.
That's
right. She's done hockey wise because she's married to Sheldon Sorey.
Hashtag fake news.
So she would slide right into Total Divas.
Okay.
Yeah.
She already does a show for E called like Wags or something like
that. What if she comes into the tag team match and beats up Nikki Bella and Maryse and is like, they need some.
Hey, if Kelly comes back, you know who else has to come back?
Michael Q. Knoxville.
Michael Q. Knoxville.
Somebody had a story about him a few weeks ago. Who was it? Because we brought up Mike Knox. Were you here when that happened?
No,
like with LaRusso or somebody was talking about him?
Mike.
So,
for the longest time, Sorg thought his wrestling name was Michael Q. Knoxville.
No, we said it so much on the show, it flipped in my head, and I only knew him as Michael Q. Knoxville.
It should be.
Because we had to stop in the middle of the show, and I had to ask, what is his real name in the ring?
Hey, he was born with banshees, all right?
Born with banshees.
Born with banshees.
Yes.
Michael Q. Knoxville.
Somewhere on the internet, there is a picture of Mike Knox being evolved like a Pokemon.
Yes. I love that.
No. Like, this is a thing we actually did on this show years ago. Doc Remedy drew up a picture of the baby Knox, and he evolved into Michael Q. Knox.
There's a question, and Billy's saying, does anyone see Kurt Angle as a part of Mania? I could see, if not that Hardys thing, like what if Usos come out, American Alpha comes out, and Kurt Angle helps him win the belts.
I don't see him coming out and helping.
No?
If there's no third person to interfere on the Usos' behalf.
That could be.
Because Alpha's the baby face, you know? They're not going to have somebody come out and interfere.
That's true.
They did it with Bayley.
I know, and it was
It's
stupid.
Terrible.
I think Angle gets
the worst.
Angle gets saved for Monday night.
Yeah.
Angle's going to be the new GM.
Yeah.
I agree.
They get a nice little sheriff badge. They keep him out of your mind, out of your head. Yeah, like I here's agree. The Hall of Fame. Yep. He's gone Monday night, top of the show. I got somebody introduced. It's Kurt Angle. Kurt Angle sets up the whole show by making a bunch of matches. That's where you get
by
your
the
pop.
Way, there is an awesome interview Corey Graves did with Kurt Angle in the net.
Yeah, I got a watch it.
I watched it last night.
It's pretty great.
It's on there. It was really good. It was only like 20 minutes long, but it was really fun.
It was a good Larry, 20 minutes.
Larry, you were saying about a baby face nowadays. What's do you that? Realize that you were saying about how like a baby face acts nowadays?
Yeah.
With like, do you realize Randy Orton burned down Bray Wyatt's house?
Yes.
That's different.
I was talking about that earlier because he killed someone.
He turned to the scene of the crime tonight. And stabbed the grave.
But the,
to be fair, someone.
Bray Wyatt went blackface. So he's automatically
the Randy.
That was amazing.
Randy Orton's always been on that edge of like baby face, kind of like how Austin was, though. You know, like you expect him to do asinine things.
Turning to the scene of the crime.
True. I have a bold prediction.
All right, go ahead, Chad.
I think Goldberg Lesnar's going to be a teardown classic.
I think it's going to be longer than
get the fuck out.
It's going to be a, it's going to be a 25 minute Matt classic.
Chad, get out.
Chad.
Get out.
Chad,
that's it. Chad, as much as I would love to hope that you're right, I was at WrestleMania 20. The answer to that is
they're both leaving at that point.
I'm sorry.
They're both leaving now. No.
They have the title on the line. They've showed Brock repeatedly get beat within a minute, and he got speared last night. You're gonna see a match. You're gonna see a real.
Do you think Brock's gonna win?
Yeah. Yes,
I agree. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Yes, mm-hmm.
I think Brock's maybe gonna win by suplexing Goldberg 30 times, like he did to Cena.
I don't think he'll suplex him once.
Ten.
It could be shenanigans. Who could you?
I think it will be around a 10 minute match.
I don't maybe know if anybody gets
my bold prediction is Scott Hall with a taser.
Yes.
Scott Hall with the taser in Goldberg's locker room.
Yep.
Clue.
Absolutely. Anybody else have a bold prediction? So we move on. Anybody else?
Missy?
You might see blood.
Missy?
In that match.
You might see blood. I think you definitely. You'll see blood and a gallon of sweat.
Definitely gonna see sweat.
I think
they're gonna skew that very much toward like a UFC style.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So you might get the stoppage for blood and then can it continue? And then that's, I think
that I match
is
going to end
that up.
That
ramp
good.
Is going to be a slip and slide.
Like the match you did with Dorian at SummerSlam?
Wait.
Non bold prediction.
If
the forklift
walking,
finally. No, good.
Go ahead, Bobby.
I was going to say non bold prediction. The forklift finally chooses a side between Dean Ambrose and Baron Corbin.
Jeez.
I want to know, are they both certified?
What are we doing?
No, I don't think so.
Who is it?
What are we doing that's not a forklift match? What's happening?
Agreed.
Who was it that Big Show faced in that stretcher match where he got forklifted out of there?
Oh, God.
Brock Lesnar.
Was that Lesnar?
Hey, it was Brock, yeah.
Brock certified. Brock certified.
Brock certified.
Brock has a farm.
Yeah,
he's
got a farm.
Yeah, you're right. He does.
Unless he's like pack mule and all that stuff everywhere on his
back.
That
one surprised me. You know, that wouldn't surprise me at all.
Towing his own field.
Moving
I should have read a book for forklifts in WWE history.
Can Brock Lesnar just come into down that ramp on the John Deere tractor and let's just have
that? Pulled by pigs.
Nope.
Pulled by pigs.
Pulled by pigs.
Like a sled.
Straw hat.
I think we have a new
Rusev
video.
Southpaw. Oh, yeah! The Rusev character from Southpaw.
Forget,
yes.
Forget Sorg. A tank.
We have a new video to make.
Yes, it's a giant.
Oh, no. Mike.
Sorg, we have a new video to make.
We do?
From the people who made Vampiro coming out to Bailey's theme song.
Yes! that cracked me up so hard.
You saw that?
I was crying. It made me laugh so
you didn't
hard.
You didn't see when they showed me the gif of Vampiro doing the dance and Mike's just like, imagine Bailey's theme.
I singing the Bailey theme song.
Yeah.
Thor completely died.
And I'm just like, this is a video.
No, I need someone to, you have to do it again, but Photoshop in the wacky wavy arm flailing inflatable tube men.
Well, no.
Next
if you
to
look
him
at the crowd,
he's going like this.
Look at the crowd. They all have their hands in the air. They are the wacky waving inflatable arm flailing tube men.
Put them Strowman costumes.
No.
It's Bailey believers.
You need to put Strowman's head on each of those fans in the crowd.
Bro!
With Bailey's music and Vampiro dancing.
To make another video.
Okay.
And instead of Brock Lesnar's theme song, we have Hillbilly Jim's. Don't go messing with a country boy. Like, come on.
That would be gold, actually.
At the same time, he's hopping in his entrance. Don't go messing with a country boy. Like,
with Paul Heyman just smiling behind him. Like,
she's taking notes, man. That's going to be her new gimmick.
That is my new gimmick.
This is going to happen.
We're going to see that at IWC.
Dude, screw everything that I've done since now. All of my bright colors, it's gone. Straw hats.
Country garb.
Yes.
Yes.
Blue jeans and wheat.
I come out with
overalls.
Overalls and wheat.
That's identifying with the crowd right there.
Yeah, right? I'm relatable, Sorg.
That's why Big Lady's so over at RWA. I'm sorry, but I'm at RWA. Do the live streams at the intermissions, right? Mm-hmm. I could not get near those people. I could not get near because they had so many fans lined up. Big Lenny and Jesse Bell Smothers.
The Hayseeds,
right? You this can't. Does not surprise the Western me. Crowd was all about that, and I'm just like, I got it. You know, I got a chance to talk to. G Raver and stuff like that. Couldn't get near Big Lenny. Mm. Big Lenny is over as
big.
He's like their Hulk Hogan.
Yeah.
He really is.
True champion of the people.
He really is.
I can't wait for his. Who's going to be his Andre the Giant now?
It's Big Larry. It's the Big Larry. I'm sorry. Big Larry.
Big Larry.
That's your gimmick.
Big Larry's here. Go. You can be my manager.
Oh, who's Big Lenny gonna buy?
Big Larry and Little Jinx.
come out, three stump hands.
Pitch that to plumber.
Like, carburetor or something from the tractor.
Come out with me throwing weed at people. Yes.
It gets everywhere.
I mean, I'll throw hay bales at people to interfere.
Have you picked up a hay bale or have
I
you
have.
Pulled it out from under the ring?
Yeah.
That would be cool.
I just imagine before the match, you're going to be the one that has to tell the ring crew, hey, I need you to put this under the ring. What do you need me to put under the ring, Lily?
This hay bale.
What do you need under the ring, Larry? This hay bale.
Don't tell plumber.
Don't talk about it.
Your opponents will be itchy.
It is really freaking itchy.
Okay? Yes.
And when things get really hardcore, you just pull out the pitchfork.
Can we do a pitchfork on fire gimmick match?
Hey, doesn't burn very well.
Only in West Virginia.
Yes. Instead of any horse under here.
Speaking of making better matches than WrestleMania, it's time for Mayhem Mania, guys.
My match as freaking the new like country person will be better than anything on WrestleMania. Me versus Britt Baker in me versus Britt Baker in a pitchfork on fire match.
She got removed from Mayhem Mania already.
Want celebrity interaction, you could get Pauly Shore to reprise his character from Son-in-Law.
Perfect.
Although
I'm ready for this.
We really could make Garza's life miserable and put her on the card.
We could. But we could, guys, but you are not going to have the opportunity.
Oh no.
Mayhem Mania. Matt Carlin is busy this week. He is on assignment. So I have been charged with handling the Mayhem Mania. I have specific instructions for what we're doing. Of course, this is our not quite a game, not kind of a contest. It's a competitive thought experiment that we're doing here to try to book a better WrestleMania than WrestleMania. Some think we succeeded. Some maybe less so, especially our graphics department. But anyways, what do we have so far? We've gone through, 8-9 rounds of it, including last week's Patreon in the Bank that added a ton of new matches. We have a graduated card, and we have the kind of undercard that still has not become official. We need only X a number of matches, and then we're going to have a vote for the top matches, so we're done with 8, I believe, that we will have a poll over on the Wrestling Mayhem Show Facebook in social media, so please keep an eye out for that. So what do we have so far? What's going on? You're moving. Why are you leaving?
I'm getting the board.
Oh, no, we don't need the board. I got graphics. It's all right. Because I don't know if the board is accurate.
The board doesn't lie.
It's like Google.
All right, double check the board that it matches this, I guess. The super card, these are matches that have graduated. They, for whatever reason, first of all, on the super card, we have a submission match. Brock Lesnar versus Kevin Owens, created by International Wrestling Cartel Rookie of the Year, Jackson Argos. And, oh, we have notes in here on who put the submission in here. That would be... Oh, geez, I'm not going to be able to follow all this. Okay, that's what we got right now. Also, we have, and with the Scott Dawson in the front now, with special guest referee Kurt Angle, American Alpha versus the Kings of Wrestling versus the Revival, originally created by Bobby F. J. Town. And we have a WLC match. Yes, that's Tiny Ladders, yes. Chairs, and Tables. Yes. The Shield versus the New Day, originally created by Mad Mike. May be the best match on the entire card right there.
Yes.
Also, we have AJ Styles versus Shinsuke Nakamura.
I'd pee my pants.
Apparently, that's the best match on the card.
There we go. Created originally by The Riz. We also have a ladder match. Charlotte versus Asuka, originally created by Bobby F.J. Town. We have a Weapons of Mass Destruction match. Bobby
Sponsored
Roode.
By Lucha Underground.
Hold on, yes. Let me get to that. Bobby Roode versus John Cena, created by Lucha Underground co-executive producer Chris DeJoseph. So, yes.
Special guest Ref Vampiro.
Oh, that'd be amazing, actually.
Yeah.
Only if he comes out the Bailey's music.
We want Vampiro.
Also, with special guest referee or a ring announcer Mike McGurk, take that out, Roker. We have Mickie James and Beth Phoenix versus Lay Cole versus Bailey and Sasha Banks versus Emma and Dana Brooke, created in some aspect here by Tragar, hence the Mike McGurk. There you go. That is a picture full of badass lady awesome right there.
Mm-hmm.
And of course, Finn Balor versus Bray Wyatt, originally created by Bobby. You got a lot of matches on here. Holy crap.
Yeah,
this is the undercard. This is what we have to play with so far this week. We got Ember Moon versus Alexa Bliss, created by Tina. We have Dean Malenko versus Daniel Bryan, created by Bo F. and Diggity.
Amazing.
It is just we figured these guys are on the level. They have enough physical capability to have a match.
That was an armbar match, I believe. Right?
It was a what?
Yes.
That was an armbar match.
Oh, it was an armbar match. Yeah, that's right. Armbars for 20 minutes and we will love it.
No harm contract match.
Mad Mike. Yes. Mad Mike created the Stephanie McMahon versus Shane McMahon match.
Yes.
Sure.
Let's do it.
We have...
hey, gender is fluid now, Sorg. It's 2017.
That's true. Eric Young versus Baron Corbin, created by Ed Burke, man of many ice creams.
Uh-huh.
Samoa Joe versus Big Show, created by Billy Johnson.
Well...
Chris Jericho versus Kane. Demon Kane, again created by Bobby F.J. Town.
Mayor Kane.
Not yet. The polls aren't in.
And finally, by IWC announcer Nick Lindell, TJ Perkins versus the Brian Kendrick versus Akira Tozawa versus Neville versus Austin Aries versus Jack Gallagher.
Didn't we literally just see
that? You might have too. Finally, Big Bartholomew versus the Sea Creature, created by Bobby F.J. Town in the Southpaw Regional Wrestling Specialty Match.
I love it.
That's definitely. Big
That's my favorite scene of him, and he's like, "Oh,
God. Oh no!"
And they just cut. And that's all he's doing. They cut away. That's it. 2 seconds.
So, what do we do this week? Great. We have all these matches. We have too many matches.
Oh no!
Each of the five players, verbatim from Mac Harlan's Keeper of the Mayhem Mania, each of the five players this week must eliminate one undercard match.
Oh man.
Undercard match?
So that's these last matches, okay. These last few that don't have the super fancy graphics.
Okay.
Especially that last one.
No.
I'm just saying on graphic level.
I still think it's the best one.
what that will do, that will leave us with three to put up for vote on the Facebook page to be the pre-show match. Supercard would be set. So this is the battle for the pre-show.
What's going on? I was showing them.
Oh, you're just showing them.
I saw the post. For reference. The post-it note that says "fuck that owl."
That's all updated. Wait, it does say "fuck that owl."
I was just saying this is all updated. This is the undercard. Yes.
Okay, so Chad to Shad, order. I'm just going
to
go.
It was Team versus Balor at one point.
Yeah. Oh yeah. That. Absolutely.
Yeah. Yeah.
That was me.
That's a match for the ages. Can I say what I think would be better with Kane? Let's do.
Are we doing picks?
Oh, I'm kind of. This is not an official pick, but I'm kind of curious what you would pick.
No, I want to say Governor Kane versus Governor Rhino.
Congressman Rhino.
Oh, yes. In a filibuster match.
I'm sorry. This sounds like it's a PMS discussion.
It is.
Political Mayhem Show. Political Mayhem Show.
Who would win?
Save it for PMS.
What if they had to debate their way through the match just by saying what moves they would do to each other?
Yes.
Not do a match.
So it's like,
talk it out.
It's like an oral EFED.
Then I'd counter
match.
It's like a
D&D. All right. Order this. Order of deletion.
Delete.
We have to delete. Delete some matches. We're going to go with Bobby FJ Town, Mad Mike, sure. Jinx, Larry, and Chad. In that order.
Oh, man.
In that order. Bobby FJ Town, you must kill it with the dose of poison.
Okay.
What match is it?
I'm sorry to do this. Since it doesn't involve a forklift, Baron Young. Sorry, guys.
It is deleted. Deleted.
Get it, Wicket.
The dog has eaten the match. The dog has eaten it.
The dog has chosen.
Put a piece of pepperoni on the post-it so the dog will eat the match.
Yep.
All right. No Eric Young, Baron Corbin. Yep. Mad Mike, you are next. Which one do you want to delete?
I'm doing this purely out of spite.
Oh, of course.
Because Samoa Joe is not booked on actual WrestleMania, he will not be booked on our WrestleMania.
Oh, no.
Samoa Joe and Big Show is deleted.
The Big Show is sad.
You got rid of the Samoa Show?
The
Samoa Show is dead.
Man.
Dead.
Hey, if Bobby can get rid of Forbearin Young, I can get rid of Samoa Show.
It was a toss-up between that one and that other one.
Jinx, which would you delete?
Okay, I say purely because I literally just saw this when SmackDown came to town.
No.
The Cruiserweight match.
What the fuck?
She's gone.
It just happened.
You're going to have a fight on your hands on that couch.
It just happened. On 205 Live, you can watch that exact match.
I saw it in person.
So did I.
I want to see it again.
But it was really good.
It was good.
But.
But.
Chad.
It happened already.
No. Don't you do it.
In the arms of an angel. Fly away.
Oh, God. That's like the Sarah McLachlan commercial.
Oh, no. Look at it.
He's
not, sad face
he's not
of
my
sadness.
Manager anymore.
The sad face of sadness.
Vaguely.
You're getting the shit boot out of you at the next IWC.
He's going to be back there at the DVD table. You just hear this in the distance. Boo! Boo!
I'm going to throw a hay bale at you.
No, I'm going to take them. I'm taking the mic from Dombrowski.
We will have a savage promo off. We will have a savage promo off.
Get the pitchfork.
Amazing. Larry.
I can't wait.
Larry, what is your match of vengeance and deletion?
Mayhem Mania is
I'm killing the sea creature.
Out of anger.
Wow.
Mayhem show.
Wicket can't believe it.
It didn't work.
Sorry, she got
rid of it. Hold on. Is Larry the banker? Yes or no?
Yes.
It's gone. It's dead. Rubber suits and all are gone.
Oh, that's rough.
We're got rid of the cruiserweights. No fucks given.
No fucks given.
It's a
hashtag it's a fuck that owl.
Shad the Shad. What we
fuck that match.
You got four matches left. What are you going to delete?
You jammed me. These are curveballs before me. Because there's two matches I don't like.
Okay, which ones don't you like?
I don't like Steph and Shane.
Okay.
I should have done that.
And I think Jericho deserves better.
I agree.
Yeah.
So.
Well, if you delete him, he'll have a nice spot on the pre-show panel with Booker T. Shucky Ducky.
Quack, quack.
I'm going to have to get rid of Dean Malenko and Daniel Bryan.
Wow.
Don't want to see 20-minute armbar.
There will not be a single armbar this WrestleMania.
No.
No armbars given.
You said there were two matches you didn't like, and you didn't pick either of them.
You know why? Because I don't like them, but
understand?
I can't take Jericho off the card at all. And I'm just going to let this ride. If nobody took care of it before me, I'm not going to be the one to get rid of that.
You're not gonna
I don't like it, but I still want to see
it. This is what you've all chosen. This is all on you. I'm not cleaning up your dirty work. I'll take what you love. Everybody else is doing
He's a Hall of Famer. He doesn't have to do it.
Yeah.
Can I say that I love that the ladies' match remains?
Oh, that's the one good match.
Yeah,
that's
the only match that's good.
Everybody wants to see it. How did that graduate?
That is the best match.
I really like Ember Moon.
I want to see a kiss flip turn into the fucking eclipse. Like, I need to see that.
There you go. So what's going to happen now is the last three matches. Hold that up so I can read that over the thing. Alexa Bliss versus Ember Moon. Shane McMahon versus Stephanie McMahon. And Kane versus Chris Jericho are the last three matches in Mayhem Mania to be selected from. This is the pre-show match you are selecting. There will be a poll on our social media at Mayhem Show, Wrestling Mayhem Show, Facebook, and group. So check that out. That will be the match added to the card, and that will be our Mayhem Mania for this year. Thank you.
Quick poll.
What's that?
Quick poll. The three matches we have left, is our pre-show better than the three matches on WrestleMania?
No. I mean, you got one glimmer of hope, but...
We would have had two.
We would have three.
Because of that big Bartholomew.
Larry.
Things are really uncomfortable on that couch over there now.
You did this to yourselves, all of you.
Mania,
don't play by no rules.
Matt goes away for 1 week and everything goes to hell.
Yeah, exactly. Everything goes tits up.
Yeah.
Damn it, Matt.
Did you see how last week went?
Mayhem Mania destroys all. Wow. On a long enough timeline, everybody gets what's coming to there.
That's right.
Mayhem Mania is the Mario Kart blue shell of wrestling.
Yes.
Yeah. It destroys friendships.
Run along.
On that note, guys. What did you learn from professional wrestling this week? Who wants to go first?
I learned that I should burn down a house and kill a woman and pose in front of it.
Over.
And cut a good promo.
Over.
And it will just help my character more.
Over.
I know. It'll make me more of a baby face. It makes me more sympathetic when I burn down a house and kill a woman.
Katie Arquette, your house is going down.
Yeah, I'm coming for you.
Wow. And you spread hay on it.
Yes. It'll just make it go up more.
The house is burnt, but then there's just like this fresh hay on top
of
the ashes.
I'm asking Big Lenny to come with me.
Like a really good grounds crew took care of that after it burnt down.
I just couldn't help myself. I needed to clean it up. I
really wanted the neighborhood to not look charred and burned. Like,
they would have put newspaper over it, but it all burned in the fire.
Yeah. We'll till it in the fall.
Fall brawl.
Farmer's market. Get your fresh grown Sister Abigail's.
Yeah. You only wrestle twice a year now. That's it.
Yes.
During the fall harvest and then spring. That's it.
Only Ember Moon. Now your character's.
Only when the seasons now you're, are right.
Ember Moon, now your character is Harvest Moon.
Yes! You know what? I love it. Harvest Jinx.
And then a man-eating plant grows and named Abigail.
Larry, what did you learn from wrestling this week?
I'm actually going to request to go last because I'm still fuming over that cruiserweight.
Listen!
So,
you mad, bro?
Hey, we may have learned
you mad, bro?
So I got to actually think of something.
I love the cruiserweights too, but it already happened.
Loves to hurt them.
Chad, what did you learn from wrestling this week?
Oh boy. Where to start?
So many things.
I learned that I really like ladder matches, you know, and I'd forgotten how much I liked them. And then as Raw was progressing, I was like, well, I really hope this turns into a ladder match because Gallows and those guys brought out a ladder.
Too early for Braun. Braun's not in that ladder match.
No, I didn't do Braun. I messed up the ladder match cue. Oh.
I did learn. That's what I learned. Match. I learned it. I think we're having we got a good tag division on Raw.
We do.
Excellent.
Yeah.
Mad Mike, what'd you learn?
I learned that John Cena can say the word pussy on SmackDown.
Billy also learned that one.
Yeah.
And but he can't say shit.
Yeah.
Right.
He could have meant a cat, Mike.
Well, I mean, no, but I mean, you know, there are different ways. No, but he was bleep for saying pussy, but he wasn't bleep for saying shit.
He also ball tapped Miz.
Creative.
Yeah, but that was really actually very funny.
Yeah, really good.
But yeah, John Cena is very selective in his curse words. It must be part of the rules of his house.
Welcome to my.
Thank you. I was hoping you would do that.
House full of pitbulls coming this fall to NBC.
Bobby of J-Town, what did you learn?
Right. I learned I'm excited for one thing. I'm excited it's WrestleMania weekend. I'm excited for one thing more than anything this weekend. And that is Asuka versus Ember Moon.
Oh, jeez. We didn't even talk about TakeOver.
I'm more excited for that match than anything else this weekend. I've been waiting for this match since Ember Moon got to NXT.
Yeah.
I think that tag team match is going to be better than it, though.
That NXT
tag team elimination match?
I mean, it's going to be great.
Here's what I learned. So I'm looking at the cards earlier today, and when I looked, I think there were four matches listed. Mm-hmm. Four listed for NXT.
Yep.
No pre-show matches that I'm aware of. They're going to have four matches officially.
Well, no, they.
And
they,
I'm just. Was that?
For TakeOver, they don't do a pre-show.
Right.
Because they filmed the next week's episode of NXT
right
before.
So there'll be more. Yeah. I mean, they will see more, but still. And it is just as exciting with four matches as the card we went over with 13. On par.
Yeah.
You know, like I will have as good a time with the 3 hours of NXT plus and pre-show than the 7 hours of Mania. You know,
if
what
it's
I mean?
Anything like last year, it'll be better than Mania.
Yeah,
right.
Last year's TakeOver was amazing,
so mm-hmm. good,
and that's why they probably didn't talk about it because it doesn't need. We know it's going to be.
Yeah.
So we're just like,
well, just the massiveness of what WrestleMania is right now.
And plus, we could still have a match added to TakeOver. We don't know what this week's NXT is going to produce.
This is
because
true.
I still think they have something with that six-man tag.
Yeah.
Mm. So with that six-man tag is going to happen.
And plus, we'll probably touch base on
one woman.
We'll probably touch base on the latest with TakeOver on the midweek war this week. So keep an eye.
Oh,
on
yeah,
that
we'll be doing. We'll be doing predictions. Absolutely.
Oh yeah. Missy, did you have anything? Nope, that's a no. We have chat room, but Larry, did you come up with something?
No. This is okay. I'm over it.
Are you sure?
No, but
not
I'm,
really.
I'm being civil.
Do you want to fight?
Insert Arthur meme.
Yeah.
Am I going to have to?
When she deleted Cruiserweight,
hold a fist from Larry.
I'm going to have to pull up a mean game of Tetris for you guys to settle this after the show. Is that what's happening?
Pac-Man.
Hay bale. Hay bale. Hay bale versus hay bale match.
What'd you learn?
I learned that having contract signings at the beginning of the show is slightly better than having it at the end.
Really?
Only because I don't have to suffer through a contract signing as the end of the show. I actually get a good match.
Mm-hmm. That's fair.
That's true.
So I would rather get that shit over with early on and then just enjoy the rest of the show than go through the show and have it be pretty good and then the main event comes up and it's a contract sign.
Plus it's fresh, you know?
Yeah.
You don't have to like wait for it.
Yeah, just rip the Band-Aid off quick.
Yeah.
Just rip the Band-Aid off. For this next one, Wheels has one here. Jinx, can you grab that fun character in the plant thing? Yeah, that guy. Right. That guy right there. So, Wheels learned that Burt LeGrand, a ring announcer for RWA, hates Groot.
Why?
What the fuck?
Push the button. Oh, he's not on! There's a
Wait,
switch.
Whoa. I got it.
There's a switch on the bottom. No, he just thought he was kind of creepy.
Does he not have feelings?
Apparently not. He hates Groot. And,
that's sad.
Was Burt LeGrand's soul also burned up in that house? At
Stop! Ring room
for the
Tina also learned that she's curious to see if John Cena's proposal to Nikki Bella could top Macho Man's Miss Elizabeth.
No,
there's going
to
be that dude in the crowd that's
nothing
going...
will ever top that.
That match needs nothing. Jerry Springer refereeing it.
Yeah, absolutely.
Here's my bold prediction on this one.
Oh, yes. Okay,
they're not getting engaged. They're getting married.
Oh,
right there.
My God, I would be so mad if they do a wedding at WrestleMania.
It's good. I'd hate it, but I agree.
It'll
Missy,
be longer
is
than
Al Roker a licensed minister?
Yes.
Once in a lifetime.
Al Roker is here. Licensed.
No.
It's going to
be Eric Bischoff.
Hashtag.
Did I hear somebody say 3 minutes,
bro?
This wedding's gone.
God, if Bischoff came back as GM, I would be so happy. I would watch Raw forever.
Kane's little head popping up through this ring.
Also, Brandon learned that there will be an actual roller coaster on the Mania set. I can't wait to see what they do with this.
I'm
one.
So excited.
I just
that's what the cam's gonna be on instead of the was it a jib?
It's a jib camera. Yeah.
So it's gonna be on a roller coaster.
I want Taker to come down it, but with dead eyes whole time, just on the roller coaster.
It's gonna be like Tommy Lee's drum set for Motley Crue.
Tommy Lee's drum set for Motley Crue.
Yeah, it was for the final tour. He was on a roller coaster and
like,
it was.
I want the camp WWE kids riding it.
Yeah.
You know, I mean,
just continuously.
By the end, they're like, guys, please.
That'd be great. It'd be great.
7 hours.
I'm going to say Eric Bischoff is inducting DDP, just saying.
That's true.
And we didn't mention Jim Cornette's inducting the Freebirds.
Yeah, holy shit.
He's inducting who?
Not the Freebirds.
Okay.
Yeah. You're just like, I forgot what you're
what? Again?
Again.
Hey, if Flair can
twice in a lifetime.
Another Arthur meme. What the?
Hey, there you go. Jim Cornette could do the wedding ceremony.
Guys, what's the over under on Kurt Angle saying the letters TNA during his speech?
I think he'll do good. I think he'll be fine with it. I don't think he'll do it.
In the interview, he said, I went to another promotion.
Yeah,
it doesn't get mentioned. No.
Yeah,
I think he'll slip. I think he'll slip.
I hope
he's going to say, fuck that out.
There's your over under.
Oh my God. If he says fuck that out, that'd be amazing.
He'll come out
He'll
come out wearing the fuck that out shirt, you know, and say thanks for the present.
I bet Jeff will be there.
What's the over under on them saying you suck?
It's going to happen.
Yeah, no,
it's absolutely going to happen.
That's how it happens now.
It's like saying Cena sucks.
Weren't they singing it when he was like announced? And the music was playing, so
yeah,
like no, that is a term.
It's just a rite of passage.
It is absolutely.
They were saying it when they were in Pittsburgh for SmackDown. Only I think it was referring to the match,
probably,
and not Kurt Angle.
Oh. Anyway,
but the thought was there. That's what counts, right?
Thank you, everybody. Mayhem Show is mayhem as usual. Thank you so much, Jinx, for joining us.
Always, thank you.
We'll have to get you back on here. It was fun.
Maybe.
I had fun. Maybe.
Maybe.
If we can reconcile our differences.
Yeah, maybe Flary will approve your return or something.
You're my manager still.
Yes.
Big Larry.
There was a note after that. It's like, well, there goes, hold on. There goes so much for the power team of IWC.
It's us.
That's you. Did you give Brandon what he learned? I believe I did. That was the thing about the roller coaster.
Oh, okay. Yeah.
Yeah. So thank you, Chad the Shad.
You're welcome.
Joining us again.
Buongiorno.
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 Mad Mike, of course. Buongiorno. Check out the Midweek War and the Raw wrap up with him. 32 Manias with Mike.
Yes. I'm excited. I hope someone just binge watches my podcast on Sunday before WrestleMania.
I'm looking
just
forward to seeing
all
the spreadsheet.
32 episodes.
I know. That'll be interesting.
I want to see the spreadsheet.
Me too.
All right.
Oh, yeah. Oh, it's good. I have to figure out how to get on to one image, but yeah, it's going up tonight.
All right. And thanks. Oh, Bobby of J-Town.
Yeah. Hi.
Yep, he's here.
Present.
Bobby of J-Town, which some of you may just think is the top half of his head if you've been watching all night. So,
or the duration of the podcast, and it's like since I've been on.
Disembodied forehead.
Disembodied.
You're like the neighbor from Tool Time.
Yeah.
So I was just peering Bobby over the fence.
What you doing?
Bobby F. Wilson.
That's amazing. Thank you so much, everybody, for joining us. Please stay with us on Wrestling Mayhem Show, at Mayhem Show on the Twitter, and all the social medias, Wrestling Mayhem Show Facebook group on Facebook. A lot of great conversation. Love having this group and seeing you guys at the wrestling shows as well. So until next time, Mayhem out. This show is a member of the Sorgatron Media Podcast Network. Find out more at sorgatronmedia.com.